Well, today marks the Jewish holiday called Yom Kippur. It is a time when Jews fast and pray that they'll be remembered in God's book of life for another year.
For one Israeli general, it's also a day to remember God's protection on the battlefield. It happened during the 1973 Yom Kippur War. Chris Mitchell has the story.
Like most Israelis, just before the 1973 Yom Kippur War, Effie Yitam didn't expect a surprise Arab attack on the holiest day of the Jewish year. Yitam was leading a routine reconnaissance patrol on the Golan Heights. Moments later, he would be facing the might of the Syrian army.
I saw hundreds of Syrian tanks just moving forward, and they were painted in their camouflage of green and yellow. And I remember I thought myself as a kind of prehistoric lizards, you know, who just came out of a cave because they came out of nowhere. I didn't see them before.
For days, the surprise attack dealt a serious, nearly fatal blow to Israel. The men on the front lines bore the brunt of the battle.
The first 3 days were hell. You know, we didn't have any anti-tank weapons, and we had to shoot them with American World War made bazookas. You know, it's a very primitive anti-tank rocket launcher, and we had to shoot them from distances of 50, 60 meters, and people just got killed. Some of them were smashed by the tanks, you know, from such a short distance.
The Israelis paid a high price in lives lost during the first few days of the war, but they held on and contained one of the most fearsome attacks ever made against the nation. When Israel counterattacked, Yitam received orders for a daring mission: go miles behind enemy lines and take the Syrian division headquarters. Like many commando raids, this assault meant close quarters, face-to-face, and sometimes hand-to-hand combat. Yitam was a highly trained soldier, but he wasn't prepared for what faced him when he went around a corner in the Syrian bunkers.
We came there and we started to kill the commanders, the generals which were there, and their guard. I was throwing hand grenades, shooting, you know, in the broad concrete corridors. And then when I turn behind one of the corners of the corridors, which was full of smoke and dust, I saw a silhouette, a kind of something coming out of the dust and the smoke towards me. I was very sure it's a Syrian soldier. And I took my rifle and I was aiming the rifle. I was ready to pull the trigger. And then I saw a bird coming out of the smoke. She just flew behind my hand and she stood on my right shoulder.
At first, Yitam thought the bird was actually a bat living in the cool, dark corridors of the bunker. So in the midst of an intense firefight, Yitam found himself trying to shoo away a bird.
So I just whipped her out, and she turned again and stood on my left shoulder. I didn't have time to have all kind of argument with a bird. What are you doing here? Who are you? It was in the middle of a shooting battle. So I completed the assault and the hand grenades and everything. And when I went out of the corridor of the bunker, I saw a dove, a pigeon, standing on my left shoulder. I just tried to let her out of my shoulder. She turned and she was very determined not to leave me. I put my hand just like that, and she stood on my hand.
Despite Itam's attempts to get rid of the dove, she stayed with him and his unit for the next 10 days in some of the most intense battles of the Yom Kippur War. During that time, Itam's unit appeared to have supernatural protection.
Since we had that angel protecting us, none of my company soldiers was killed or wounded. And we were involved in very intensive battles. It's not that we stood in the rear or we sat there. We were involved in the middle of the most bitter battles, but she was there. What was unnatural and very interesting was that even in the night, when we had night operations and night battles, where usually these birds, pigeons, do not move at night. They don't have a very good night sight. She was with us, patrolling a little bit forward, looking what's going on around, sitting here.
Finally, after nearly 2 weeks of frontline conflict, Itam and his unit were sent to the rear for a rest.
And when I put my feet down the vehicle which brought us from the front to the territory of the State of Israel, she flew away and disappeared. You know, you could have a little bit of questions whether it's happened or not, but it didn't happen to me in the middle of a desert or me being alone in the middle of a jungle. It was in front of the eyes of thousands of soldiers.
Since that experience, through many special commando operations, the sense of the miraculous and God's protection has never left Itam. The same protection promised in the 23rd Psalm.
I trained myself to see miracles around me, around the operations which I conducted. It's as we know, gam ki elech begeitz al mavet lo yirara. Even when I am in valley of death and evil, I'm not afraid because God is with me.
Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.
Absolutely amazing story.
Powerful story, powerful story.
God
love it.
Was with them in the midst of it for 10 days.
Oh, beautiful, wonderful.